What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I am back to inspire you to be great. Yeah, that's right, to be great, not only in this game, but also in life. Remember, guys, I am your number one fan. I really do believe in you, so keep going. Getting bad FPS, or just lagging in general while playing Fortnite is one of the biggest factors that hold a lot of us back from being really, really good at the game, right? And often make players, including myself, extremely mad. You know, experiencing bad FPS, stutters, input lag, or any other performance issues when you play, you know, you're not gonna be in luck, you know? So in this video, we're gonna be breaking down a bunch of different methods you can just use to get higher, more consistent FPS and overall performance in game, and give your game that buttery, smooth feel that we all love. If you follow all the steps in this video, you should get higher FPS, less input lag, you know, no stutters at all, and overall, feel like a completely different game. All right, so before we get into this, we gotta do the question of the day. I gotta ask you this question. What FPS do you guys get in game? And, you know, what impact do you think it has on you? Let me know in the comments. I'm really curious to find out what it is. And if you want to become an elite player, just like the ones you watch and look up to, head on over to ProGuys.com, which is going to be linked in the description. Okay, so on our website, we offer a ton of courses from pros like Mongrel, Letchi, and Benji. And we have some new ones coming out really, really soon. We can't tell you exactly who we're doing them on just yet, but trust me, you do not want to miss it. We also offer 24/7 on-demand coaching from some awesome pros to help you guys step up your game. If you want to get better at the game faster, ProGuys.com will be your best friend. Now head on down in the description and check it out. So we've got to start it off with the simplest step, which is updating Windows. All right, so if you've had a bad FPS or degraded performance, there's a good chance that your Windows is out of date, and there may have been an update released that fixes your issue, right? Okay, so the way to do this is super simple. Just head down to the bottom left corner of your screen where your Windows search bar is located and type in check for updates. Click on the first result and you're gonna be brought to this page right here. Press the check for updates button located near the top. This will tell you if your Windows is out of date, in which case you wanna, you know, quickly update it, or if the page says, you know, you're up to date, then you've got nothing to worry about. All right, guys, next up, we're gonna do a virus scan for any unwanted software or viruses that, you know, may be hindering your performance. It's actually surprisingly like how many viruses can be on your PC, and most viruses slow down performance a ton. So this step is absolutely crucial. So it's best to use Malwarebytes for this one, since it's easy to navigate and scans thoroughly. To download Malwarebytes, simply just go to malwarebytes.com and on the homepage, press the free download button. Okay, so from here, do all the basic installation stuff and then go through the software using Malwarebytes free instead of the paid version. Unless you just wanna go to the paid route for some, you know, extra benefits. From here, okay, so once you finish the installation and setup, you're gonna have this big blue scan button in the middle. Click on this one and let the scan run its course. Depending on the speed of your PC, this might actually just take only a few minutes, or it might take a long while. So once you're all done, it's gonna give you the option to remove all your quarantine files if there were any. So click on that option if you have it, or if nothing is detected, then you're all set. So now that we're all done with the scans and checks, we're gonna be moving on to the nitty gritty stuff. All right, guys, so to start, we're gonna be taking a look at our storage drives. Believe it or not, you know, the majority of people who have bad FPS have it because their storage is overloaded. You always wanna leave about 25% of the storage on your drive open, or else everything else is gonna take forever to load. So to do this, head to the bottom left search bar, right, and type in File Explorer. From here, on the left-hand side of this new window, you're gonna see My PC, or one of your main drives. Click on this and scroll down. Whichever drive you have Fortnite installed on should be the one that you're looking at, all right? If you have 25% or more open storage, then you're all set. If not, it's absolutely crucial, guys, to delete some of these things and just bring your storage numbers down. If you need to open up more storage, head on over to your search bar and then just type in add or remove programs. On this page, you're gonna have a giant list of, you know, really pretty much everything that's installed in your PC. So just go down the list and just remove anything that you don't want. Second, go to your search bar once again and type recycle bin and select the recycle bin icon. If anything is in here, go ahead and select it and delete it. Finally, if this isn't quite enough, head into your file explorer once again and go through each folder, especially your pictures and video folders, which often take up a bunch of storage, and delete whatever you no longer need. If you don't delete anything, go back to your recycle bin so you can just get it off your PC completely. All right, guys, next up, we're going to be resetting our Fortnite config so we can get rid of any issues with our game and optimize our settings. All right, guys, so to start, head to the search bar and type in the percent symbol, app data, and another percent symbol. On the top bar, click where it says app data and then go to local. From here, I mean like right here, locate your Fortnite game folder and rename it to anything you like. From here, simply just launch your game and just wait for it to load up. It should take a bit longer as all your settings and configurations are being reset. So once your game loads up, you know, you can head into your settings and modify everything to your liking once again. This shouldn't really take very long, and you know, as this only resets your display settings and nothing else. So while we're at it, make sure that you're on full screen, your shadows are off, motion blur and VSync are also off, and that our DirectX version is set to 11 and not 12. As you know, DirectX 12 is known for causing a bunch of crashes. And hey, since you're already in Fortnite, you know, you might as well head into the item shop and put in code PROGUYS to help support us for bringing these daily videos. You know, just want to put that in. You know, it's just really best to do this at least once a month, guys, or maybe just once every few months, because sometimes suboptimal settings or issues within your game files can cause you unnecessary lag. You're better off safe than sorry. All right, guys, so the next tip is a super easy one that you can use to free up some extra space and possibly improve performance. Simply just head on over to your search bar, type percentage temp percentage, and go into the folder and delete everything. Then go and empty out your recycle bin like we've done in previous steps. For our seventh trick, we're gonna be running a program called CCleaner to free up even more space and make it just a few small optimizations that's gonna help our computer run faster. Okay, so to start, go to ccleaner.com and download the free version and go through the installation process that you would for most of the programs. Once you finish installing it, press Run CCleaner and it'll bring you to this page. Click Analyze in the middle and run the analyzer. Once the program finishes analyzing your computer, it's going to remove any trackers or excess files from your system that you no longer need. Review both to make sure there's nothing you need for any reason. Then go ahead and click Clean All if you're all set. Once you finish this, the finish screen will pop up, meaning you're all set. All right, guys, so our eighth tip is going to be changing your in-game resolution. This is a pretty simple one, but can provide some amazing benefits in terms of FPS. So we recommend sticking to, you know, native resolution, you know, as it has the highest FOV available since stretch resolution was patched once again. But you can use, you know, any native resolution that you want, all right? The only difference is that, you know, a lower resolution will look a bit less crisp, but it shouldn't really hurt your gameplay at all. All right, guys, so to lower your resolution, simply head into your game and into your display settings, and at the top next to your window mode and frame rate limit, you're gonna be able to adjust your resolution. If you're currently playing on, you know, 1920 by 1080, which most of us are, and you change your resolution to 1600 by 900, your computer will have to render about 30% less pixels, which will drastically improve your FPS and performance. So if you go all the way to 1280 by 720, your computer will have to render about 60% less pixels, which can turn horrible performance into amazing performance. If you want higher FPS and you don't mind adapting to, you know, slightly less pixels on the screen, this is the method for you. So if you followed all of these steps and you've done them properly, you should see your FPS and performance going straight up. Let's quickly recap everything that we talked about in this video before we finish up. All right, guys, so the first step is to update Windows so any performance issues related to your Windows versions will go away, and to ensure all these upcoming steps work for your system as well. Second, do a virus scan using Malwarebytes to get rid of any unwanted software or, you know, viruses that might be slowing down your PC's performance inside and outside of the game. Third, make sure that you have at least 25% of storage remaining on whichever drive that you play Fortnite on. This is going to ensure loading times are fast and that your drive doesn't have to reduce your game's performance to make up for slow loads. Fourth, guys, by resetting your Fortnite config, you're gonna be fixing any messed up, you know, game files, and you're gonna be able to re-optimize all of your in-game settings to make sure, you know, none of them are causing your system any issues. So we recommend doing this once, you know, every month or two, or at least with the release of each new season. And next up, head into your temp folder and remove all the files that you're able to. This is gonna help reduce some micro stutters and, you know, free up just a bit more space. Try doing this like once every few weeks or so after doing it for the first time. All right, guys, so after deleting the temp files, use CCleaner to get rid of any extra unnecessary files, trackers, or anything else slowing down your PC that we haven't caught with any other steps. And finally, guys, like if you do all of this and still want better FPS, consider, you know, changing your in-game resolution so you don't have to render as many frames. But, you know, just be aware that the game won't look nearly as good if you do this. So we only recommend doing this if your performance is still struggling, even after all of these other tips. All right, guys, once again, this is your motivation guide. Thank you so much for watching the video. We really hope you enjoyed this one, and we hope that these tips and tricks are gonna help you guys out with your PC optimization and allow you to get better performance when you play. Comment down below, you know, what you thought about this video and what you'd like to see next on this channel, because we strive to bring you guys daily quality content. So do us a favor by liking this video, subscribe to the channel, and show ProGuys.com some love. We'll see you next time.